Pooblad.
Oh shit, he's at war with Pooblad.
That's all he needs.
Holy fucking dog shit.
He's at war. Like, I don't know. A lot of people, a lot of the East Coast, they're letting down. I don't know. They just, like, they do randomly good, and then they just suck. And then...
So you're pretty much saying Fublot's consistent enough for you to pick him on a team as a steady pick.
I'm pretty sure he'd swing at somebody.
He'd swing? What do you mean?
He's the Hulk player. He just... He swing.
Oh. Okay, yeah. So, okay. Someone's going to randomly walk into one of those melee swings by the Hulk, and then he'll be able to execute and finish. But so do you know who's on the West Coast team, or even is that team not selected yet?
I mean, it's pretty much usually like the same five guys always.
So it's Justin, Fnatic, what's this guy's Filipino champ?
Probably Combo Fiend.
Combo Fiend.
Maybe Infrared, I guess.
Yeah, perhaps Infrared this time. So, me personally, I think the team should be you. I think the team should be you, Marlin Pie, Yipes,
and Moons.
Ray Ray.
What about Dominion?
And Fublot. Dominion's not a Marvel player. Nothing against Dominion. And the thing is, his team, the entire team he has isn't solid enough to fight against, like, the big boys.
Man, fuck that. You need Team Soulfish against the fucking West Coast. That's what you need.
Nah, man, that's...
I say Dominion, shit. Chris G, fucking Nerd Josh, and whoever else uses fucking Morgan.
If it was that simple, then everyone would just pick Morgan, and all the finals will always say Morgan, but only one Morgan wins in the entire nation, and that's Chris G's. So that literally deflates that entire argument.
Hello, gentlemen. Hit your speaker. Walker. Yep, there you go. All
right.
Hold on a second. Let me plug in a better headset.
Hold on. Yeah, I guess I'd probably pick, like, me, Yipes, Flocker.
Oh shit, Flocker. Oh wow, we forgot about Flocker.
Yeah.
Ray Ray.
You don't think
Marlin Pie? I don't.
The reason why I select Marlin Pie is because outside of fighting your annoying Sophist team, Marlin Pie touches them, they're dead. When you really look at Marlin Pie losing, he always loses to fucking Sophist. So, why is this guy? Yo, Nigger Six is crazy, B. What is him? Is this dick shit?
What the hell?
It's just all day in the room. It's just been dick.
I mean, you know,
he's trying to get your attention.
They're trying to, you know, it's a cry for attention. Is exactly what it is. You know, I mean, sometimes, you know, this is, you know, the only way people can get their dick fetish out is in chats. So apparently, you know, they're reaching out. They're basically like plenty of fish. They're just casting out the fucking rod and hoping they attract somebody that says, "Hey, I want dick too." You know, I mean, unfortunately, because I have a no ban policy, I really can't do nothing about them. So, I mean, either somebody take him up on his offer if you're interested, or tell him to shut the fuck up.
Oh, man, the MKJ show is crazy.
What about CD Jr.?
What about CD Jr.?
He's already occupied with dick.
Oh, damn. 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 Damn.
He's got a little bonfire going up there in the Bronx and cuddling up with a couple of his homies up there on Tremont, you know, and fantasizing about what he's going to do when he gets home with his boys. That's just the way he rolls. I don't begrudge a man for that. But, you know, if he focused more on playing MK than Dick, he'd probably get a lot better.
Well, see, I will tell you one thing I respect about CD Jr. You know, everybody, no one's innocent. You know how everyone's like, oh, this guy's like this and that guy's like that. This guy's not an asshole and whatnot. And then some people like, well, this person talks shit behind this person's back and whatever. Everybody talks shit behind everybody's back. And like, people need to grow up out of that nonsense. Cause like, we all know this, right? But the one thing I will say about CD Jr. as a person, this is what I like about him as an individual. This man wins Ohio, right? Makes 12K. And this man supports his mother, spends more time with his family. Now, he's a family man. And people don't even know it. And you got to respect that about a family man, despite what anyone says. Like, that's what I like about him as a person. So at the end of the day, when, you know, like, people are like, oh, man, fuck this guy because of blah, 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 blah. At the end of the day, I can look him in the face. I'm like, you know something? You're a decent human being. I can't say that about a lot of people.
You can't say that about me.
Well, at least you're honest. At least you're honest.
Nah, you kidding? I love my wife.
Oh, wait a minute. Let me press pause, unpause, so I can see the stream. I want to see if she's behind you when you said that.
Nah, she's nowhere near. Okay. No way. Okay. If she was here, I wouldn't say it.
Oh, man, that was a troll.
I don't want her to actually hear that. Then she'll actually try to control me, and nobody can control me. That's what the OBS show is about. Nobody controls us. We do what we want to do.
Wives control. Wives control their husbands in bed.
With a 2x2 box.
Oh, yeah, okay.
With a 2x2 box, they control everything in the world, and that's reality.
James,
let me tell you something. If you were with a girl and you weren't and you weren't getting a box lunch, trust me when I tell you, your ass wouldn't stick around.
No, that's true. But what I'm trying to say is this. There are, as a man, there are nights when your wife is there and she's like, look, motherfucker, this is how it's running. And yo, you gotta just let shit happen, B. It's called the night when a man is defeated. It happens all the time. Men always destroy their women at night, but then there's some of those days, B, your wife just puts it on you and you gladly accept the L.
Yeah, see, familiar stranger saying Latino women fuck you instead of you fucking them. And you know what? You're right. He's right.
Not all the time.
When I met my wife and my wife turned around and she says, you fuck around on me, just remember, Lorena Bobbitt was my neighbor in Ecuador. That's when I kind of went, oh, really, huh? I said, remember this. If you fuck around on me, I got to send four-pound packages down to Ecuador every month. That's a maximum I'm allowed to send. You weigh about 100 pounds. That's about 25 weeks before the body gets down there.
Oh, shit.
And from that point on, we had an understanding.
So was that the precursor to the – was that foreplay? Like, is that how it starts for you?
That's how we roll, man.
That's the dirty talk.
I'll cut your fucking heart out. Or I'll stab you when you sleep. I'm like, oh, I love you.
Yeah. Oh man, this is crazy.
But anyway, let me roll back here to Mr. Chris G. So, you know, and this is something that I hit on, and I listened to the Wule show, and I know you hit on it a bit. What do you got to say to the haters? See, everywhere else you don't really vent. I want you to say exactly what you feel for all the people, and I've seen it firsthand, who basically say you're nothing, you're this, you're that, da 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 da. But at the end of the day, you play more games than any player out there that I know. I mean, unless there's some kid somewhere that I don't know about, and you consistently place top. But yet, for some odd reason, I don't see you putting in 25 million hours in all these games. So I look at it and just say it's a natural talent you have to read these games. With MK, obviously, you know, I always see you, unless you're getting DQ'd, you know, I always see you placing top 10. You know, when was the last time in an MK, besides being DQ'd, did you not?
Yeah. The hate is strong. I'd rather joke around with it. I feel like that's more entertaining than actually like trying to address it and like getting mad about it. I don't know. I really got nothing to say to those guys. Like everyone's always saying, well, you know, you got your opinions and whatever. I just like whatever they want to say, they say it. I play to play. If I want to troll Grand Finals, I'll troll Grand Finals. If I want to quit Grand Finals, let me quit Grand Finals. Like, whatever.
I mean, I think it was what? Was it NorCal or SoCal or one of the tournaments you just got up and walked away in the middle of the match?
Oh, yeah. Like, there was no way of winning. So instead of waiting for the next 15 seconds to run out, I just got up and left.
I give mad props for that. You know, that's like a final, a fuck you. Yeah, you won. I'm out of here. I love that shit. You know, when I see, you know, in fact, when I was at Summer Jam, I somebody pointed it out to me, and apparently I friendshipped somebody in MK2, and before I even finished doing the move, I like got up, walked away, then turned back to it, did the move, and then left. So finish him came on, I got up and left, and then I said, oh, wait. And then I did it and then walked away. Didn't even acknowledge the guy. Was it kind of dicky? No, it wasn't. You know, I look at the earlier versions of MK as that was as much a part of playing the game was that cockiness. That's why I won't mention other names. When I see cockiness, I'm like, you know, I've gone down that road. It doesn't end well. Usually you just get labeled as a dick. Now, if you truly don't give a shit what people think, that's great. But at the end of the day, you know, whether it's Marvel, Street Fighter, Mortal, you're a part of every one of these communities. You know, and, you know, even especially here, you know, obviously everybody here would agree that you're obviously a force to be reckoned with. Is MLG a possibility for you ever, or is it just something that you don't want to partake in? And I actually know the reasoning why, but is there a chance you could possibly start going to MLGs?
If MLG stopped being stupid, I guess, with their tournament dates, then maybe I'd make it down.
Because, you know, it'd be nice to see another addition to the top 8, top 16, which I obviously know would be you, who plays with just, you don't go in with crazy-ass combo. You play with fundamentals, you know.
Yep.
You know, MLG is clueless about MLG. Exactly, CD. Yeah, MLG is clueless about MLG. That's what you said, CD. I agree with you. I'm going to NEC. I'm not going to Dallas. You know, I've said this over and over again. I support the grassroots side of this, you know, the tournament scene. And being the old motherfucker that I am, if I got to die like a dinosaur with the grassroots, so be it. That's where I'm going to be. I don't see there being an MK after Dallas anyway, but that's my opinion. Chris G really doesn't know anything about MLG. That's a CD Junior remark to you.
I think we're gonna see MK next year at MLG. Call it a hunch.
Not if they get a 40-person turnout at this next one.
But I don't think they'll get a 40-person turnout for MK.
I mean, the numbers are going down. You know, and I get people bashing me for my opinion, but like you say, fact of the matter is, turnout goes down when frustration builds up, and the fact that the community, you know, this bonding that I wish, this whole Lollapalooza thing, MLG doesn't want to grasp that. They don't want it to be fun. They want it to be business. And as a businessman, to me, it's not economically advantageous for myself to go to a tournament knowing I'm not going to make top anything. So I'm basically going there to donate my money to top 16 players. I am real with myself, and I know I'm not going to place high. So what am I going there for except to give away $600 in travel for the airline, whatever
so
I spend in a hotel?
So are you saying that the answer to the problem would be Tom Brady's great tournament, great experience?
What is that?
Oh, what is that? Oh, you never heard that from Brady?
No. I've heard his saying, but what is the great tournament, great experience?
Great tournament, great experience means that he played in a tournament. I forgot where he got it from, but win or lose, the purpose of the tournament is to enjoy yourself at the event, and the tournament to be able to provide a great experience for those who win or lose at the tournament.
Yeah, I agree with that. I would agree with that 100%. You know, I mean, yeah, you're going to have your top 16, top 8, whatever winners you do who make their money. Is it going to be, you know, $12,000? No. But you know what? You know, for a perfect example, we had the MK Flash Dancers on here 1 week. You know, you have the MK Flash Dancers. You know what? You turn around. You got somebody like Pig the Hutt who's a musician and he's got a band. You say, hey, look, you know what? We're going to throw you a couple of bucks. Bring your band here. You know, turn it into a Woodstock per se of gaming, but at the same time still hold on to the competitiveness to a degree. So even if you are not winning, it's almost like an E3 for the average everyday Joe with the competitive side to it. You know, so I mean, I would definitely be all for that.
Well, I will say this, and I know you're like, oh, here comes Triforce defending MLG. But when I go to MLG, but see, they do it mainly for the like the whole the StarCraft and the League of Legends.
Yeah,
they have kiosks there where people can just play those games. If you're not in a tournament, you know, you can still compete. Come on, don't be taking away yes, I got my flush. So yeah, don't. There's games there for everyone to play. Mad Catz has a booth where they have Cross Tech in there and whatnot. They had a Mortal Kombat, a PlayStation Vita Mortal Kombat tournament. Winner won a PlayStation Vita, whatnot. They had a Persona 4 tournament on the side. Winner, I forgot what the winner won and whatnot. They had Virtual Fighter there as a side game along with Skullgirls. So they're trying their best to accommodate the people who go there who don't play Mortal Kombat and Soul Calibur and accommodate them with other games there. And I think once they get their footing in on the mainstream part and this thing becomes the standard, you're going to see more people going. I think you're going to see Chris G going there after a while. I just think you don't see Chris G there a lot because of like he stated, the dates. And I don't want to necessarily blame the dates on either the community or MLG, because I know what it is when it comes to the dates. We'll leave it at that.
Oh, I mean, you know, other things, you know, you got Beefuteki here. You know, he's pretty much one of the if not the, you know, the big streamers for the community, for our community, just yes. Like 9.95. You know, these guys, you know, they're out there. These are the guys they should be reaching out to.
But, okay. All right, I agree. There's no way
I'm going to disagree with that. If you want to display, whether it's true or a bullshit deal, if you want to show the communities that you're serious about inclusion of the community, you got to take the key parts of the community and add them.
Now, when I'm not trying to put anyone on the spot, I'm simply speculating. When you look at the situation, I think that's what Ataro was hired for, to find. Now, before Beefuteki came on the scene, they said we needed somebody that can do the production work for us in terms of the streams for the fighting game community. I don't know why they didn't take Spooky himself, but they selected Arturo, and that's pretty much the same thing. No offense to Victor. I don't want anyone to take that as an insult. I'm just saying that Arturo works closely with Spooky and in developing Team Spooky as a whole. So and then Arturo actually has IT background. I don't know why they didn't get Spooky. Who's to say Spooky turned it down? We don't know. So I'm not going to go there. I'm just going to leave it at that. With that being said, from there, Atara went into the community and selected 9.9 Phil, selected, what's this guy's name? Bibulous, right, for Soul Calibur, selected Answer for King of Fighters. Tom Brady even got in. So they did that. There is no place in time where MLG is like, okay, we're not interested in working with gamers from the community. We want to get our own guys. When you look at the people that's running MLG's broadcast for the fighting game stream, it's people from our community. I'm just calling it what it is. That's what I see when we go there, and I'm sure that's what you see when you go there. And I'm not trying to shit on you, James.
I know you're not, but you know now. Where is Phil?
Where is Phil? Okay. Well, someone's got their stuff in the background. Real talk. This is off the record. This is the On Blast show. Nothing against Phil. He is my man, 50 grand. But word is on the streets, Phil sucked at what he was doing and got replaced by Tom Brady. I'm just saying. That's word in the streets.
Wow.
Word in the streets.
I liked having Phil. To be honest, I liked watching Phil commentate. I liked Phil having commentate. I'm not saying nothing against Tom Brady either. I like the way he commentates. And I'm not trying to shit on Juice Box, but I think I would have rather seen a Tom Brady and Phil.
See, that's where the word in the streets come from, because so many people say this guy should have stayed, that guy should have gone, this guy should have dissed. That shit's been there for
Juicebox, you know, he's a great guy, don't get me wrong, but his MK knowledge is less than
100%.
So
my opinion,
between
I think
Phil
that
and Brady
been,
between Phil should've. And Brady it would have been a great team.
This is what it should have been. It should have been Answer, Juicebox for KOF, Bibulous, Jaxel for or Atara, Bibulous, Jaxel for Soul Calibur, Brady and Phil for Mortal Kombat. And Atara just stays in the background, makes sure the names are put up properly, the production's running, blah, blah, blah. But that's just me. It's not my business. I don't run the business. I can't tell them what to do. But if I had a hand in what should have been happened, that's what it would have been. It would have been those six people. But then at the same time, I don't know what the original number was. I think Atara was given a number amount of people he could take on board, so he had to make it work with whatever the number is, I think. So there's a lot of things that go to it, and it just oh man, esports. That's all I have to say, esports. So they had to mix and match based on the people that they selected, and they got rid of certain people based on opinions of their performance, and that's why you see who you see.
Well, like I said, I'm not shitting on no one person. I shit on them all. By the way, Bibulous, you can suck my dick, you big fucking goofy bastard. You better buy me a drink next time I see you.
What the fuck? How are you going to call him a big goofy bastard and ask for a drink?
Because I bought the motherfucker like 75 Jackson Cokes and fucking at Evo. The motherfucker could have at least gave me a goddamn cigarette, cheap bastard. You got a paycheck.
Goddamn.
Guy tells me, I'm gonna help you with Soul Calibur. I ain't never heard from the motherfucker since.
Oh.
So, anyway, Beef with Techie, what's your opinion?
Oh my god. Holy MK James.
Dre, you there? Uh-oh. I think Dre dropped off. No, he's still here.
Stand by.
I think he's beside himself right now. I mean, like I said though, guys, you know, as far as Chris G goes, in my opinion, as I say, Rio is the best overall MK player out there. I think Chris G is the best overall rounded player out there. And you know, as Triforce likes to say, that's my opinion. That's real talk. He's the only guy that I know that goes to almost every game and consistently plays his top.
In the fighting game community, Chris G is undoubtedly one of in North America currently, because there are different ages. For instance, the overall best fighting game player in Japan is Tokido. That's not a question. In the old age, the first dynasty, the overall best fighting game player was Justin Wong. In the new age, the best overall fighting gamer player is Chris G. this I don't know why this is an argument.
How old is Tokido?
How old is he? Shit, I don't know. Be honest with you, I actually don't know.
How old are you, Chris?
21.
You got a long way to go, so you got a long time for dominance.
I don't think age matters, because this is video games. This is not an athletic thing.
We also got to admit this: as age kicks in, your reflexes do slow down.
No. Sanford is 30 years old,
and that's he's at his prime right now. It goes downhill. It goes downhill from 30, man.
It's a mentality thing, man. It's a mentality thing. It has nothing. Alex Valle, Jason Cole plays. Went to the Capcom 25th anniversary. Jason Cole played Super Turbo, Third Strike, and Street Fighter 4. Jason Cole's 37. The issue here is this: when you reach a certain age, you start to look at the game differently, and the hunger disappears. The skill doesn't disappear. It's the hunger. And when the hunger disappears or the hunger subsides slightly, you don't have that edge. But it's not a skill thing, because it's like riding a bike. If you ride a bike when you're 20, when you're 18, when you turn 50 and you don't ride the bike in 30 years, you're not going to sit there and say, I can't ride the bike anymore, or I'm not as good as I ride the bike. You get back on the bike, and if you go, I really love riding this bike, you will ride the bike like you were 18.
Let me tell you, son, I would agree with that to a degree. And, you know, they say once you learn it, you don't forget it. But there is this, you know, if I was 16 on my little BMX bunny hopping and jumping over cars and whatnot, and then at 40 I decide to get back on that bike, I'm going to bust my ass.
Yes, but because it's a physical thing. That's why. But in video games, it's not. It's a mental thing. Dora Self was the Qbert world champion when she was in her mid-age. She died at 82 years old, and she was a Qbert champion
Now you're comparing apples and oranges, because you're comparing a game like Qbert, which is her versus a computer, compared to me versus Chris G. Me trying to outreact Chris G is like, you know.
You trying to outreact Chris G is based on whether you know you can read Chris G. Reaction is only part of the game. If your mentality is at a level, okay, here's an example, right? Alex Valle has been playing Street Fighter for who knows how God long, right? Since Jesus was walking on water and shit, right? Nothing against Alex Valle, right? He played against Sanford. Sanford has better reaction than Alex Valle to a certain degree, right? Somebody got a speaker on? Oh.
Sorry, that was me. Go ahead.
Okay. Alex Valle now is playing Sanford. Alex Valle is able to read Sanford, and with his ability and skill to react, he reacts to it. The reaction only comes after the reading. The reaction is if you can't read someone, you have to rely on the reaction. But 90% of the time, it's not reaction. Someone is reading. Daigo's parrying of Justin is reaction. It's not a read. First of all, there's a startup to the super, so you see it. The super has this whole lighting effect before it happens, and he's like, okay, I gotta react to this. Parry, parry, parry. Parry, 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 because that's the motor Ingrams that's built in him based on playing that game is reacting. It's not even him physically reacting. He's just used to it. So he reacted towards that. I haven't played Tetris in collectively in the last 2 years in almost about a year or so. But if I sit down and play the game for about a month straight, I'll be back to where I was godlike back in 2008. You see what I'm saying? Now, that it doesn't matter what age I get to, I will always be like that. Billy Mitchell set 800,000 points when he was a kid in Donkey Kong.
Now, motherfucker put 1.62 million up in 2010. He's 47. So it's video games is different. You can't, that the getting old is not an excuse. It's a friggin' video game. It is not an excuse. People use that excuse because they just don't have that hunger no more. And people just need to call it what it is. Yo, actually, I'm older now. I got priorities in life. I don't see video games like how I used to. And that's what it is. I play it casually. I have fun with it. But the competitive drive is gone. And that's what it is with you, James. You are more of a community person. You're into the community of Mortal Kombat. You're not really into the competitive aspect anymore. That's why you don't do as well.
Well, that's because the game is ass. But that's besides the point. If the game was structured better and actually put together to be a competitive game and not a broken game, I would definitely probably take it more serious. You know, I mean, but the simple fact is that the game is broken, and it's been broken since day one, and it's not broken for no other reason except for people bitching and moaning about it.
Yeah,
but
that's true.
All these games out there,
mm-hmm.
whether it be, you know, Marvel, Street Fighter, of course, Tekken, Street Fighter 4, they're all broken. You know, they're all broken in their own ways where you're basically left with these learning curves that they're instilling in these games that make them, you know, less competitive, more everybody gets a gold star for trying type mentality. And with that said, you know, is there still high-level play? Yes. But, you know, if you look at these games from an outside perspective, looking in at the competitive scene, you kind of, you see this, you know. Yeah, Billy came in 56th out of, you know, 30 people, but he tried, so it's good. You know, it's kind of like what people would say about, you know, if you break down, let's say, Street Fighter 2 as an example, mm-hmm. you know, Zangief in the beginning, you know, everybody said, oh, he's ass. No, he's not. He's ass if you can't get in. But if you get in, he rocks everybody's fucking world. You know, but yeah. It was that skill set to get in. Now, if you break down the characters in a world of matchups, was there a best character and a worst character? Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, everybody wants everybody to be the same. Everybody got to be the same. Why can't one guy suck and the other guy be good? You know, it gives you, I mean, I use crappy-ass Baraka, you know, for a reason, because I know he's a low-tiered character, you know. But, you know, the Baraka players will be like, well, he needs this, and he needs this, and he needs this. No, he's fine the way he was from day one. You know, from day one, he was fine. But, you know, people bitch about Pigs Kenshi. There's a way around it. He hasn't won every MLG. He didn't win Evo. So obviously there is balance to the game to a degree. But when people say, well, this character needs more buffs and this one needs nerfs, it's like, dude, you know what? Learn the program and make a game. Don't talk about it. Do it. You know, and if you want to play a game competitively, don't worry about the checks and the balances. Worry about just playing the damn game. If there's some kind of bullshit, and I think I heard Chris G say on the Wule show last night that he'll find something fucked up and he'll use it till he's blue in the face.
That's because he's smart.
Yeah, it's what it takes to win. You know, when I watched, and I'll say this, you know, before, and I've watched matches of Marvel versus Capcom, you know, but when I watched Yipes and Chris G play at Summer Jam, I actually found a liking for the game. Just watching the way they played the game, the way it was a back and forth. When they did the East Coast versus West Coast, it was entertaining.
Yeah.
You know, but if you look at the game,
it's very fun to watch.
But if you look at the game in a balanced aspect, you know, they kind of taken they've kind of taken from the Marvel Capcom 2 day. Of, you know, and the infinites back then were a lot. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, Chris, but were the infinites harder to do back then than they are now?
Oh, hell no. They're mad easy back then.
So those ones are easier?
You can't do infinites in Marvel 3. Get out of here.
So you can't do infinites in this.
No, you can't do infinites in Marvel 3. They don't. The game isn't designed for it. So
I mean, you can do it, but it's too hard.
Well, because it depends. Yeah, he's right. Actually, I'm not even going to go against that. He's actually right.
I see it like this, because I've seen a lot of people attempt to do infinites in Marvel 3. Like at Evo, people were attempting it. People were attempting it at Summer Jam. People were attempting it at different tournaments, and they all fail. They drop it at some point and whatnot. But I think that they were easier to do in Marvel 2 than they are in Marvel 3.
That does not go against the fact that Marvel 3 is an easy game, and this is what people are going to have to just accept and stop bitching about. Games being made easier is a positive thing. It is not a negative thing. I don't know why everyone's complaining about it. It is a positive thing. If they do not make these games fair for everyone to play, then I don't even know how to explain this, but like, you're pretty
EMP Sanford?
EMP Sanford, what? What happened?
EMP Sanford.
What about EMP Sanford?
Complains about the game every 5 seconds.
About Cross Tekken?
No, Marvel 3.
Oh, no. Like, well, Sanford, no, it's a dip. Like, okay, I'm not trying to, like, make excuses for, like, guys like Yipes and Justin and what. Those guys, they are the only people that can legitimately complain because they were used to one way, and now that way no longer exists. Everybody, the competitive Marvel scene wasn't as big. No, wasn't, shit. Was never as big as the Marvel 3 scene right now. And that's the truth. So a lot of people were expecting like the Titans to come out and blah blah. Remember, you was going when you were Empire, you used to go to when Nelson and them was talking about, yo, listen, we're gonna put you on our wing and blah blah blah, and we're gonna take you to the Titans house and everything. Everyone was expecting that, but it did not pan out that way. The game was different. It invited a new age of players. That's why we call this age the age of the new gods on some like DC shit. Because that's what it really is. And you're considered one of the new gods. And that's what it is. Now, they could do two things. They can either like it or leave they it. Can go find a new... Yeah, leave it. It's that simple. And like the days of Justin Wong having an entire year... Did you know that there's a recorded year where Justin went to every single major in the year and won? Along with winning Evo. A lot of people don't even know why. He won every major in the year along with the world championship. That's when he was the god back then. Now, Justin is lucky if he can pull off a two or three tournament win streak. Two or three major tournament win streak. It's just not built. The games are not built that way. And now gamers are feeling a lot more comfortable competing because they see that there's a chance. Not that they're going to go to a tournament and they're going to play someone who's going to do this one move and go touch, and then they sit there and they watch their game. People complain about watching Marvel 3. Shit. I was in Chinatown Fair where, man, let Yipes touch you with Magneto. You would get off the game, go get four quarters, and by the time you come back, your team is dead.
Hey, Jade Pimp, you got anything to add to this? You're all silent over there.
Oh, I was just listening.
And Chris.
In the chat with the guys about Capcom games and how AE 2012 is really balanced.
What? I didn't hear that part. Could you repeat that?
Oh, yeah. I was having a discussion in the chat room with the guys about how Arcade Edition 2012 is really balanced.
Oh, hell no.
You don't agree, Chris?
Oh, no.
Why not?
It's not balanced.
I think it's balanced. You know why I think it's balanced? Compare it to the other versions. Then you'll see the balance.
Yeah, but you know, when you're comparing broken to brokener, is it really any less broken?
Yeah, exactly.
That's the way I see it.
But then, to answer that question, if you compare broken to broken, perhaps broken is the new standard for balance now. ever thought about that.
Yeah, but you know what? You being an old school guy know that the whole object is to make a complete game. And the fact that these companies, whether it be Capcom, NRS, Namco, they're putting out these games and
casual friendly so they can drive sales and get more people in to develop the new market in gaming, which is esports.
But
so,
you know what? They could do it in a way. They can do it in a way where they can program these games and they can have idiot savant learning curve, or as an option to shut it off to make it a competitive game. It's something that can be programmed into the game. B&Bs and all this other negative edge shit, you know, shutting shit like that off and turning
this is the problem. Guys like you, James, you want to fuck up the established order. You're trying to create shit that makes sense. Why do people
sense? Why do I want to make sense? You know?
Yeah, why God the fuck forbid. Would you want to do that? What is wrong with you?
Well,
like,
I think
on,
that,
man.
You know, every MK character should have an instant kill button where they just press it once. And if
like
the other guy ain't blocking, like old school, like Eternal Champions and shit.
Persona 4 has something like that.
Does it?
Yeah, you got to get a full bar, but once
oh,
you get that
right.
full bar.
Oh, that's
right.
What do you do? I think it's A, automatic
no, that's
A.
That's automatic super, but if you just press down 3 times, and I forgot, like in 2 buttons, it doesn't insta-kill.
But did not come from that came from Guilty Gear first.
Mm-hmm.
Heaven or Hell to Destroy.
Yeah, Guilty Gear had that.
Guilty Gear started that fucking instant kill shit. The dumbest shit I've ever seen in my life. But I don't know. Like I just think I don't see this is how I believe. If everyone, and this is not trying to like me and Chris G got our differences, but I will say one thing I like about it, which I argue here in the arc all the time when I tell people, I say, listen, the age of who's the most skilled, that's the dinosaur age. That's me and your age, James. No one gives a shit. That's just the fucking truth. No one gives a shit.
No. Nobody cares.
No one cares.
Nobody cares because you know what? There is no more dominant. I mean, look at MK. As a perfect example. You know, everybody says, well, this guy's the best, this guy. How can you say that when every other major is a new winner?
Exactly. You just have champions. That's it. And people just need to stop bitching. It sounds like a bunch of old crying-ass men arguing, oh, my character's no good no more. Man, listen. This shit is esports now. Now this is about winning. That's what it comes down to. And I try to instill this into my guys. Listen, we've won enough. You guys need to take the Chris G mentality. Pick what gets the fucking job done.
And if that means punching your opponent before the match starts, go right ahead.
No. No.
If you put tears in his eyes before the match, there ain't nothing to cry about when he loses.
You cannot fucking do that.
I did that to Blue Nine, actually, from up in Boston, came down to Summer Jam. And I told him, I said, if you beat me, I will meet you outside in the fucking parking lot, and I will knock you the fuck out. And he went, what? I said, I'm just kidding. Or am I? I don't know. We'll see, though. Good luck. And he beat me. And then he's a fucking trolling motherfucker. He turned around to me. He took 3rd place in MK. And I'm outside smoking a cigarette in front of the hotel. And there he comes walking up to me, spinning his little medal in front of me. Going, hey, Jimmy, what's going on? I said, you keep spinning that fucking metal, I'm going to stick it up your ass. You know, but, I mean, he's a great guy. You know, I got nothing against him. But, you know, it is that, you know, I am, you are, the olders, the elders, I guess.
Actually, we're called elder gods.
I don't like it. I don't like being called elder nothing. but, you know, the point is, it's like, yeah, I'm willing to admit that I am a dying breed. You know, the age of
skill, you know, and all that shit. Get the fuck out of here. You think this shit is? That shit is over. Motherfuckers need. You want to get good? You want to watch skilled shit? Go rent that movie, The Best of the Best, back in the 80s. Then there you go. There's all this other shit.
That was Chris Penn, man. Don't mess with Chris Penn. He's dead.
I forgot about that. My fault. Even I knew that the age of skill is over. That's why, like, we had this big argument earlier this year. I said, I'm going to give it this year is going to be my last hurrah.
I went to the Iron Man tournament. I won that. I won a local Street Fighter tournament. I won that. Then I set my two little fucking measly world records, and I was like, I am done. It is time for me to bow out, get behind a desk, and push a pen. Real rap. Like, people don't respect that, but that's what the fuck it is. Like, what is an old ass man like me gonna do? Man, no one gives a shit about that. No one gives a fuck about Mario and Tetris and fucking Donkey Kong and all this bullshit. What's Mario? Like, people want to see this new shit popping. Halo 4, Tekken Tag, Street Fighter. This is evolution. People don't like it.
I'm curious though. What is the next direction? And you know, this is going to Chris and Beef Futeki as much as you. What do you think the next direction of Street Fighter is going to be?
I'll let them answer first. I don't mind if I go last. But I talk so much.
I think Chris just dropped out of the call.
Did he? We
gotta
shit.
Got to call him back.
I have a Maria. Where are you?
Your mom.
I'm here.
Shit.
I don't know. Like, to be honest with you, I don't know where they would go. Basically, I feel like they made a game like this that's easy for players to just pick up and play and things like that, and basically try to do that whole learning curve that they did before, where you get games like, you know, Capcom versus SNK 2 or even like a Street Fighter 3, Third Strike come back out again, where, you know, you have to have some type of advanced skill. But you can't learn that unless you pick up the game and you actually play. Mm. So it's like right now they have, like, you know, the people buying the game, playing the game and stuff like that. And the game is super easy for everyone to pick up and play.
Not to cut you off, Beefoteki. James, Chris is trying to get back into Skype. He got cut.
Oh, yeah, I'm adding him.
Okay, go on.
But I really don't know if they're actually going to do something like that. Who knows? They might continue making these games very simple for anyone to just pick up and play, and it could be played at all different types of levels.
Is that your point?
That's how I feel.
Okay, let me chime in on that on the last point, because I'm going to agree with you 100%. They are going to make games easier. If you look at the games that they're making, video games is about just becoming easy. The most popular competitive video games are all the easy ones. Marvel vs. Capcom 3.
Okay. All right, you're back.
He's back?
Yeah, he's back.
He's back. So I just got to mute the stream.
Well, he just has to turn off his
speakers.
Yeah, speakers, because that's where the sound is coming back from. It's feedback from the sound. Yeah. Chris.
Hey, what's up?
Yeah, you have to turn off your... Okay, go ahead. Never mind. It's off.
You're good.
All right. when you look at it, League of Legends, this game is the easiest form of Dota art.
I seen you tweeting about it last night.
Yeah.
Don't worry. I was fucking with it, too.
It's the easiest game amongst the RTS games, so to speak. If that is, I don't even think it's a real RTS, to be honest with you. It's more like I don't know what the hell it is.
It's an OBS.
I don't know what the fuck that is. That's complete. It's alien to me, I'll tell you that much. But people play it because it's easy. It has the most people in it, and this is where the business comes from. MOBA. Yes, thank you. It's a MOBA game. This is where the business comes in. Riot Games has now an $8 million Season 3 tournament coming up next year for League of Legends. People wonder why Marn quit fighting games. I can give you 8 million reasons why he quit. And as long as making video games easy keeps bringing out these numbers, why wouldn't a business continue to keep making the games easy? It's in their best interest to make it easy. People that don't like it, they can go fuck themselves, because guess what? Multi-online battle arena. That's literally what it is. Zaro or whatever your name is. Is that what you would call World of Warcraft when they did PvP?
I ran out of cheese doodles.
Oh shit, now you just made me hungry. Why'd you do that?
All right, well, before you get in total cheese doodle mode, so what do you think the next direction Street Fighter and Marvel Capcom are going to take? Or do you think they're just going to rehash?
Well, I think Capcom is going to most likely try to fix up Cross Tekken, because that game is a disaster. As for Marvel, though, I'm not sure what's going to happen with that game. Since licensing costs so much for that game, like, to do anything with it costs a lot of money, since Marvel's a bunch of cheap guys. And
yeah, but they got movies coming out. As long as they got movies coming out, they got characters they're going to want added.
Just like they did.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, you know, their business, you know, you built it off of them. Now you can't, unfortunately, I mean, what are you going to, I mean, you could do what? Street Fighter versus Capcom, but not for nothing. I really don't give a shit about Bionic Commando or freaking, who else do they got that's actually mediocre at best? Sector Z. Remember that game, Triforce?
Oh, shit. That, you know, that's Captain Commando. You know that, right?
Yeah, I know.
See, but the thing is that I noticed with the Marvel versus Capcom series is basically every character in that game either had a movie or a game coming out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, they did that intentionally. That was part of the deal.
Yeah, that's part of the whole deal why they did it. It was because they either had a movie coming out or a game was coming out with that character featured in it.
And if I remember correctly, Beyond Avengers 2, I think Marvel's releasing the Inhumans. And there was like one or two other movies that they got slated for the next 2 years.
Guardians of the Galaxy,
yeah.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you'll see, I can guarantee you, you'll start seeing characters like that. I mean, not for nothing, I mean, I'm beta testing the PlayStation All-Star game, and I'm not impressed with it.
Oh, me too.
You mean Smash Brothers Melee?
Horrible.
Yeah, Smash Brothers Melee 2.
Yeah,
Smash Brothers Melee 3.
Yeah, I mean, I was kind of digging Parappa Rapper for a little bit, though.
Actually, it's Melee 4. It's 64 Melee and then Brawl. So this is Smash Brawl. This is Smash Brawl PlayStation Edition, and then Nintendo's coming out with their own Smash Brothers. So I guess that would be 5. But James, what do you think about this? Here's a little spin on this. I think the next Street Fighter game is going to be 3D.
I don't think they're going to go back in that direction because I still don't think the technology plays out well. It was kind of like when Mortal did it, you know, sidestepping fireballs and uppercuts and stuff like that for Street Fighter and Mortal has never worked for the simple fact that it so dynamically changes the gameplay. You know, it pretty much nullifies the special moves in the game. That's why games like Tekken do well, is it's more based off of punches and kicks rather than throwing shit at each other.
Namco's actually making that Tekken Cross Street Fighter for
3D.
And I worry about it because I don't. I mean, has anything come out on it yet?
No, nothing has really come out because it's slated for next year, November. So we shouldn't see. You probably won't see any gameplay footage until like February of next year.
No one cares about that game.
This is what I will say. The reason why they're forced to go 3D. Is because as esports expands, as I learned from when MTV was doing a documentary on me back in 2006, the lady's name was called Elsa Fernandez. She told me something that stuck with me till even this day about bringing video games to the screen. If they cannot find a digestible format to bring the game to television, the game's not making it, period. It has to be so dumb people can understand the game, or it's just not going to sell. And that's just from a marketing standpoint. Straight from a marketing standpoint. That's why I said Injustice is going to be the Injustice, Tekken Tag, DOA, Virtual Fighter, Soul Calibur. These are the 5 gateway games into bringing fighting games to the mainstream, Why? Any regular person who's not into video games can turn on those games, watch a professional play the game, and have an understanding who's getting punched, who's getting slashed, who's getting kicked. We can understand that. When you put a game like Marvel and you say, we're going to put Marvel on television, no one can understand what the fuck Zero is doing, what the fuck Morrigan is doing, or Doom with the poopa poopa footai. Everyone's like, what the fuck's going on?
The best way to describe it, it's like watching a fucking screensaver with just like fractals exploding on the fucking screen. You just see purple, hot pink, green, yellow, and every once in a while a little fucking raccoon run across the screen, or Magneto fucking shit out some magnetic balls, and you're going, or Sentinel throwing out a million things, or fucking a shopping cart getting slammed across the screen, and I'm going, dude, I have no idea what's going on, but it looks fucking cool. But now, I can't figure out, like, at the end of the day, like, even like when I was watching Chris G and Yipes play, I'm like, who won?
And you see, James, that's the problem. That's what these network television people are scared of. When they did the whole thing that they were trying to do on me was this thing called Upsets. Remember the whole True Life, I'm a Gamer shit that they were doing back then for MTV? Do you remember that by any chance? Okay. So they were doing this little True Life, I'm a Gamer thing for MTV. So I wanted to get Justin on a show. So it was me and Justin. We was in, what's the name of this thing? We were in, Laser Park. There it is, in Times Square. Remember how Laser Park had those little arcade games in there?
Yeah.
Okay, so there was a Marvel game down there. So I was trying to impress. This is me trying to sell them the show because they want to just do a show about me and my Power Glove, and I thought that would be a fucking whack-ass show. So I was like, we should do this thing like with the whole Empire Acadia thing, going to Canada, you know, doing our thing out there with the Star Wars theme. So I was trying to sell Justin so hard. I said to the lady, yo, this guy is very good at this game. Like, you got to put him on. He's the world's best. And she was like, okay, what game does he play? So it was Marvel vs. Capcom. So I said, Justin, show her how you play Marvel vs. Capcom. So Justin put in his quarter, right? Actually, it was 50 cents at the time. He played the first round computer. Justin decimated the computer and perfected the game. The lady looked at me and was like, what happened? There's a big-ass perfect across the screen. And she looked at me and said, what happened? That is what you're going to get when you bring those type of fighting games to mainstream television. No one's going to, the average person's not going to understand. The average person will not understand.
I mean, Triforce, think about this. It could work both ways. Like, older people could see their favorite comic book hero on the screen doing shit that they imagine when they're little kids and just be totally impressed by that and keep watching.
Then answer this question for me. Which multi-million dollar company is going to risk it could happen both ways? Who's gonna put up the money to risk that? Exactly. This comes down to business. And motherfuckers, risk management, their team is gonna sit down and their marketing team is gonna sit down and say, listen, what is the risk on the return on my investment? Yes, and that shit's gonna get shut the fuck down in the fucking corporate office. That shit will die in that conference room. I swear to God, that shit will never leave that fucking conference room. That shit's life will end in that motherfucking room, because I've seen it happen so many times over. I watched them butcher projects that I thought would be godlike, and these guys was like, I'm not risking that money. No one wants to say, I think it's going to work, and put their job on the line. Because in the business world, if that shit fails, guess what happens to you? Goodbye. And people got families to feed. So they're not risking their job, their comfortable life of making $250,000 a year or $50,000 a year, or whatever is it that they're making that pays the healthcare insurance, that pays the mortgage, that pays the light bill, that pays for their car, and putting their kids through the street because we think a game is going to rock on TV.
get the fuck out of here. No one's doing it. And that's why I gotta give MLG their fucking credit, because they're taking the risk. They gassed CBS into believing this shit's gonna work. They got them to say, okay, let's make a risk. Whoever made that marketing plan is a fucking genius. That motherfucker should get the Nobel Peace Prize. Because if this shit works, as much as we may not like them, we got to take our fucking hats off to them. Because they got that shit on some Star Trek shit. They got that shit where nobody has gone before.
And I will agree with you 100% on that. And like I said, my only concern about it is the attractiveness. It may attract, you know, and I debated this with Carlos a couple of times on Twitter, and I said, look, you know, I am a rarity. You are a rarity. Alex is a rarity. We're not the norm. I can guarantee you, if I got a, you know, my brother is 2 years older than me. If he got it, and he watched me play games from day one, you know, from 1975 till now, he's been watching me play.
God damn, you're older than dirt.
I'm 37 years gaming, man.
All right.
And with that said, my brother will never, if he had to choose between, and I don't give a shit what game it is. You could put, my brother was a pro football player. You could put Madden 62 on the screen. He don't give a shit. He's not going to sit and watch what he used to play to compare to watching the real Giants play on TV. And this whole esports thing, which, you know, hey, if it works, I'll be the first to say, yo, Sundance and the rest of the Partridge family, you did a hell of a job. You know,
you call it a Parsons.
You know, you did a hell of a job, and I give you a hands down saying you shoved it in my ass unintentionally, and you proved that I'm wrong. But I just don't see the older generations playing these games. And, you know, basically, Carlos was saying, but you're here. I said, but I'm a rarity.
Well, here's the thing. That, believe it or not, that's not necessarily true. All the OGs have turned into some, have gone corporate in some way or another, James. If Alex Valle is running his business now, what's this guy's name? Jason Cole is trying to, I don't want to put his business out there, but he's going corporate as well, right? What's this guy's name? The guy from Complexity.
These are businesses revolved around a community, which, you know, without the community, they got no business. These people are the regular Joe. Can you see, if your pop had no idea and you never picked up a Nintendo game, can you see your pop plopping his ass down in front of a TV and watching Injustice, really?
No, but they can get people to watch it. What they're trying to do is they're trying to bring a new form of entertainment to television. This is why when people go, it's esports, I tell them it's not esports. It's digital competitive entertainment, because that's really what it is. And as long as they harbor this dumbass title, esports, this shit really isn't gonna go anywhere.
No, because that older generation is looking at it. You could call it esports, p-sports, g-sports, whatever. It's not a sport to them. And if it's not a sport, they ain't gonna relate to it. If you give it a name that people can relate to, you know, mm-hmm. then, I mean, you could turn around and, you know, I joke around about motherfuckers dressing up with aluminum foil out in the forest swinging sticks at each other, but call it an episode of Monty Python and motherfuckers will sit and watch it.
It's like Vince McMahon. When he got in trouble with the whole World Wrestling Federation name, well, the Wildlife Federation, he had to change the name in the whole nine yards. What did Vince do? Everyone was comparing wrestling. No, they were saying wrestling should be put. Remember in the Daily News and the Post when they said they should put the results of wrestling in the back of the paper with the sports results? And there was a huge article by the New York Times saying that wrestling, WWF, isn't a sport. And they were arguing it was entertainment. And then what did Vince McMahon do? This genius went out and said, we're going to turn this into
World Wrestling. They took out the F, and they're gonna make it World Wrestling. The World Wrestling Entertainment, right? And this was about sports entertainment. Then guess who they used? The greatest man in the history of wrestling, who literally revolutionized wrestling, not because of his ability to wrestle, but because of the ability to execute the vision of what Vince McMahon was looking for in competitive wrestling entertainment.
Hulk Hogan.
The Rock.
Hulk Hogan.
Nope.
The Hulk Hogan put him on the mat.
No, yes, for the WWF. But who revolutionized it and changed it to the WWE?
Stone Cold Steve Austin.
No, because
it was The Rock.
Wait, Long Island's own Mankind. Mankind from Long Island, yo. Getting thrown from that cage by The Undertaker onto a bed of fucking thumbtacks. After that, I went, yo, Vince McMahon's a sick motherfucker.
Listen, that shit did not sell nothing. It brought people who are the hardcore fans of the WWF. All these people you guys are talking about, Hulk Hogan, Mankind, what's this guy's name? Undertaker. That all those guys are the old school guys that brought entertainment through the wrestling. When Vince McMahon went out and got the men that mattered, it was Triple H, right? The new Shawn Michaels in Randy Orton, The Rock. These were the showmen where the storyline around them and how they entertained the people through the storyline is what elevated. Come on, last year The Rock got into the ring for 20 minutes with a stool and a guitar. What the fuck does that got to do with wrestling?
It's entertaining, man.
Exactly. And he was able to change. He was able to change the way we viewed wrestling. He was able to change the way we saw wrestling completely. And that is why, this is why he can come and go as he please. And now when you're looking at these guys, you have this, who's this fucking whack-ass guy? This fucking fake Dolph Ziggler, GM, whatever these guys' names are.
CM Punk.
Most of these guys are based off storylines now. It's not about who can out-wrestle. No one cares. The Goldberg shit don't work no more. I'm tired of seeing The Undertaker bury people. I don't give a fuck about Kane. Like, come on. Let's say today's Tuesday. Last night, look at the demographic. They use Twitter as a social media experiment. What do the fans want? Fight it out, something else, or hug it out? People wanted to see them hug it out. This shit was 53%. This is
stream monsters troll the polls.
It doesn't matter if the stream monsters troll them. People wanted to see Kane hug Daniel Bryan. And for 20 minutes, anyone who watched that watched to see if these two dumb motherfuckers were going to hug each other.
And they did.
And we did.
Wow, that's fucking twisted, man.
Vince McMahon is sitting there stroking his own meat like I'm a fucking genius.
Generation P in full effect. Who the fuck watches a wrestling match and wants motherfuckers to hug?
Clearly the year 2012.
Holy shit. I want to watch a boxing match and watch two guys fucking French kiss for an hour.
But watch it. Someone says, what a joke, right? But you want to hear the bigger joke? The joke is this. Of all the programs on the USA Network.
Number one.
They're number one, and they were given a three-hour slot. I can't remember a show that ever had a three-hour slot on network television, satellite television, or cable television in the history of TV.
And 1 hour of it is just fluff and bullshit.
Yeah.
Can anyone think of a program that had that? Can anyone? No. This shit is long. Nitro.
Yeah, where's Nitro now? Oh, wait. He owns it. He owns them all.
Nitro? Yeah. What? What? Nitro? What? Am I going to use a Stone Cold here? What? Nitro? What? The fuck out of here, Nitro.
When he had Turner come out to that fucking ring, I was like, yo, this fucking dick is a genius. And then when he went public, yo, his stocks are doing well. I mean, he changed the face of the entertainment. and that's reality, you know. And, you know, the demographics is a lot broader because, I mean, believe it or not, to some of the older guys that are used to the, you know, the Bruno Sammartino days and shit like that, they're turned off by the entertainment aspect of it now. And it's more geared towards, and he plays the game because, you know, he runs the show for whatever, 3 hours. And at 10 o'clock, he puts his, you know, MA-14 up there. But, you know, damn well, that same kid that's 14 years old that's watching it at 9 o'clock at night watches it all the way to 11.
Exactly. And the thing is, now people sit there and say, oh, man, Vince, you're selling out. No, Vince is selling in. He's changing and adapting with the times. That is a sign of a fucking good businessman. And that's what it is. And when you look at MLG, MLG is following the very same model. They're having their little bumps here and there. Shit happens. This shit wasn't always easy for Vince back then. Yo, Vince went through some shit changing the game up. He went through some shit, but he got
especially,
it changed.
Especially when he has wrestlers doing favors under the desk.
Oh, shit. Hey, man, part of the business. Part of the business.
Hey, you want a headline? give me some head.
You got to give me a headline. Well, guess what? That's no different from what the girls are doing in the fighting game. What girls are doing in the competitive gaming scene, period.
Really? They're
doing the same shit.
What am
Fuck
I doing
yeah.
wrong?
What do you mean? What do you mean?
What am I doing? I'm going to make some fucking superstars out of some of these gaming girls.
Let me tell you something. The shit I know about these gaming girls. Yes, remain no comment. I don't give a shit because I'm single, so this shit does not affect me. But the amount, the gallons of semen that has been intaken throughout the fighting game, the competitive gaming scene.
From the gallons.
Gallons. From Halo.
A big fucking vat of that shit.
From Halo to StarCraft. League of Legends, to Street Fighter, to Marvel, to Madden, you name it. The amount of semen transferred from one man to the stomach lining of a female in this competitive scene, they might as well just go and do porn. Fuck it. Real talk.
All right, real talk. Any girls out there that are looking to make a name for themselves in the gaming community, I'm looking for a female co-host. One of the requirements is you have to be able to do what that chick was doing on the video that CD Junior did. And you're going to have to be able to at least handle at least a gallon of semen. And then you got the job. I don't care if you even speak my language.
Yo, there are guys in the StarCraft community, right? They can't speak a lick of English. Yeah. You know something? People make it sound like this is just what happens here. Did you know that like they were talking about two players from the Olympics, I'm going to withhold their names, went off record to say that at the Olympic Games, so many orgies were happening between all the athletes. I'm dead serious. So many orgies will happen between the alley because this is just the nature of people. Like, that's just what it is. Like, people want to sit there and act like they're all the fuck out of here. People be doing some shit, man.
They ran out of condoms.
I would think that they would have condoms because the amount of shit that happened. When some female gamer decides to be smart and say, I'm going to make a Wendy Williams show for gaming. I feel sorry for the female gamers in this scene.
Yes.
Because that girl is not only going to make so much money, but you think the On Blast show is on blast? Man, listen. Girls are going to have to be careful. Y'all going to have to keep your business behind locked doors because dudes are going to be on some world star hip hop shit. You got to be careful that they ain't got no cameras because, yo, videos will pop up on that show. That shit will be the most watched show in gaming. Whoever does the stream for that, their Twitch TV partnership will be in the millions.
Beef with Techie, man. Keep your eyes out. You want to get that stream.
This isn't fair. But this isn't fair to gaming girls. This has nothing to do with being fair. This is just exploiting the business. This is natural business ethics. People are like, no, Triforce is not natural business ethics. Yes, it is. This shit is exploited in every facet of business on the planet.
Doesn't matter where you go. That chick that goes picks up her boss's laundry while he's in the office, trust me, she's doing more than that.
Exactly. Oh, I don't do that with the boss. Then how come you get to go to the Poconos every 2 weeks? That's none of your goddamn business. But it is what it is, B. It is what it is. And the part that I hate is when girls go, oh, men subjugate them to this type of shit. We don't do shit. Choices are made. Because I don't do that.
Well, I will say this. I will say that boy, Aries, man, what he did to that broad on that show.
That was wrong.
That was just, I mean, and I'm not getting all emo here, but yo, that was just fucked up.
If
that was like my sister or something, yo, I'd be knocking that beard right off of him.
Now, to play devil's advocate, you know what I'm, guess who yes, I'm going to blame? I blame Capcom.
Oh, I do too. They allowed that to happen.
They could have stopped it, but they didn't. They let the shit rock. I would have stopped the stream, walked up to him, get the fuck off the stream, go home. Done. What do you mean? Come on, this isn't a normal blah, blah, blah. I don't give a fuck what you consider normal. This is a liability to our brand. Get the fuck out of here. Came back on. We apologize for the rude blah, 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 blah. Whatever, whatever, whatever. Capcom does not condone such yada, 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 blah, 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 blah. And then we are replacing him with X, Y, and Z. The community would have trolled Capcom and said, oh, you're full of shit, blah, 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 blah. But guess what? There would have been no Kotaku, none of their little fucking bullshit-ass version of the story, painting it one way, and blah, blah, blah. Oh, because you ever noticed the only time they want to promote shit is when it's negative. They never want to promote it when it's fucking positive. You know, so all that type of nonsense. So I don't know. The scene is going to conform. Gamers don't have choice. Publishers don't have choices. Nothing. The Illuminati got this game down pat. Motherfuckers are going to, they are going to bend to the will of their new virtual slave masters or they will die. That is it.
Well, I'm motherfucking 300, man. I'll stand on the bridge alone until there's nobody else left, but I'm not going down like that.
At least you know you're going to die. That's a difference.
I know this. I do know I'll die. And like a wolf, I'd be like, yo, I'll jump in the fucking lion's mouth so the other nine of us can eat. So what? I might not make it out, but, you know, I'll take the chance. As long as when it's all said and done, the community as a whole survives.
Let me ask you a question. What if I told you there was another way?
I don't like guns.
Yo, James, you're crazy. No, there's another way. What if I told you that following esports so that it can set the new age and put things into perspective will then eventually have a kickback and turn around and empower the communities to grow better, where then you can provide a niche market which keeps the traditions of the way things are.
Actually, I got Beefu Techie saying he's got to split out. You splitting out, Trey?
Yeah, I'm heading out now. I gotta go.
You got some shout-outs you want to get out there? Everybody check out his streams all the time.
Just everybody just stay peaceful and stop causing shit.
War!
Peace, love, and harmony, man. Everybody go check out Local Battles, too. You got Chris G, sponsor. Beefy Techie's down there streaming. Great place to go, especially if you're Marvel guys or Personas or any Capcom game that's out there. You know, you guys have got your get-togethers, what? How often, Chris G?
I'm not Local Battles anymore. I'm Finger Cramp. But they do locals every Monday.
So
for
guys,
whatever game that pretty much people want to play. And usually that's Marvel.
That's Marvel, guys. You know, it's Marvel. I can't play it. I'm too slow when I'm too old. But, you know, it let me have some turbo buttons or some macros and maybe I'll get good at the game.
You see, you just gave Capcom the next good idea.
I just did. Everything's macroed. You're going to have 14 buttons. And, you know, 10 of them are just going to be instant moves. You don't have to do no joystick motion or nothing.
They already did that. It's called simple mode.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. Best combos for you.
Wow, that's hard. That's horrible. Chris, what about getting MK there again? Well, he was saying, Claude, that he's not at local battles, but I'm going to reach out to John and talk to him about that and see if we can maybe get something going again.
But that's not up to any of them. It's up to pretty much the lazy guys.
The who?
The lazy guys.
Who's that?
The community.
The lazy community got to get their asses out there. You know, if John, you know, is willing to whip something together again, you know, New York and New Jersey got to show some support. Tri-State guys got to come down and show that there's a reason to do it. You know, but you guys also got to keep in mind, like I said, VSM plans on coming back. Shock and Summoning have the Red Bank going on. Also, they're going to have casuals in between there at their establishment. You know, you don't want to overexpand it. You can't do, you know, a local battles, a, you know, Red Bank and a VSM within 3 days and expect everybody to show up. So, I mean, that's something that, you know, everybody in the tri-state area, or should I say the community leaders, like, you know, like Phil, like Shock, like John at local battles, they all got to talk and figure out the best way to do this.
They soon will be able to do it. This is what, and I'll tell you why they'll soon be able to do all of that. This is what I see in the future for competitive gaming. I see an age where once the leagues are established, the leagues can then, for advertisement purposes, using social media networks, Twitch TV and whatnot, and whatever media companies that's going to get involved. You see the people who are running tournaments? Those guys will be inducted into league development programs where you see how there's a Big Two, there's a Wednesday night fights, there's a Thursday night throwbacks, there's a local battles, there's a eight-way run, blah, 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 blah. When companies can find a way to now make esports a global conglomerate where they're making so much money off of advertising, these companies can sponsor these locals as standard. You said the NBA or not? Let's look at the baseball. Baseball is better. See how baseball has like 100 something games in a season? Is it 100 something games?
Yeah.
Oh, it's 100 something games, right? 100 something games in a season where teams now will be formed. You have your finger cramps, you have your DMGs, you have your EMPs, you have your EGs and stuff like that. And all of these companies are either owned or they have some type of partnership with a team owner or whatever. It's bringing in millions of dollars and they can sponsor their teams to go out to these tournaments on a regular basis. Then numbers showing up will be irrelevant. The venue gets paid, the tournament organizer gets paid, the teams get paid, the coaches get paid, the managers get paid, and all of this money is being made by the advertisements sold through the people who watch on Twitch TV. The money is to be made there. This is where they're going after. And once they get that shit, man, listen, we ain't even going to talk about this shit because they're going to get there whether we like it or not. And when they get there, it is going to be a glorious time for us. That's all I have to say. None of us will have to worry. Chris G will never have to worry about going to a tournament anymore and having to wonder about whether or not someone found out some shit about his fucking style of playing and they have to fucking switch teams and do all this bullshit, blah, blah. He's just going to go there and just play. Win or lose, he's going to be like awesome. And making $250,000 for sitting on a fucking bench.
Wow, Chris G, bench warmer.
Definitely.
Ain't nothing wrong with getting paid $250,000 just to fucking sit on a bench. Half the fucking NBA does that.
Yep, actually,
yeah.
3/4 of the NBA does it.
You know, but, I mean, like I said, I'd love to see that happen. You know, first of all, unionization is going to have to happen.
Yep.
That's a guarantee, you know, and what that does is that complicates things. And I know, like I said, you know, when I was talking to Carlos earlier and we were comparing our apples and oranges, you know, and I think he mentioned the NBA. And I said, yeah, but, you know, the NBA was actually formed from consuming like 5 or 6 different leagues. It wasn't just, you know, some guy said, hey, let me make the NBA, and it was made. The next thing that people got to understand is you don't just walk to the fucking Knicks and knock on Dolan's door at the Garden and say, hey, I'm here to play for you. You know, if a scout or a college don't pick you up, you ain't getting there. That's the difference with the competitive scene.
I'm going to start with you.
You know, that's the difference between the competitive scene. Little Billy, who's 8 years old, can just show up to these tournaments. So there's no separation of the talents unless it's the literally the top 16 of an MLG. You know, that's how you separate it. But now you're talking 16. Let's just say hypothetically with MK, for example. Let's say there's the top 50 guys. You cannot make a league with 50 guys. You can't.
No, you can't. You can't.
You know, and some people are realistic and they say, look, you know what? Like I said, you know, I break the top 50 mark. I'm content. You know, I'm content with that. I don't have a desire to get to the number one spot. Would I love it? Yeah, but you know what? The only way I'm going to do that is if I dope everybody up the night before, and then I show up and I win. You know, but I'm also realistic where a lot of other people, the younger talent out there who don't have that money to travel. You know, they don't have the money to go to, you know, Dallas, you know, to spend $600 in hopes that maybe I'll make it. You know, it's kind of like watching a show like American Idol or one of these where you get that one person that, you know, and their town, they were like, yo, everybody thinks I'm Pavarotti when I sing. And then all of a sudden they sing in front of Simon or something. And he's like, dude, you sound like ass. Why did you even come? Because they went there with that dream of it. You know, and I'm not trying to discourage people from going to it. I'm just saying, you got to be realistic.
But, James, look at this. Did you know that there was a time when MLG did not allow players...
to just come, yes.
To not just come, but have sponsors and advertise sponsors on their broadcasts... Or things of that nature. You couldn't have a sponsored shirt and blah, blah, blah. There was a time. Now MLG allows it. See, they've grown a lot. Like, the MLG is like, people not giving it its proper due. But, you know, I may not, you know, see eye to eye with certain things about them, but look, they're gonna make this shit work. I see them making this shit work.
It's to be seen, you know. I mean, it's not, you know, as much as it's going well for them right now, it's an uphill battle for them, and I know that. And, you know, hey, I'll even say, you guys ever want to, you know, mash minds together, me, Sundance, and fucking Adam, I'm willing to talk, you know. Talking don't hurt, you know. You could turn around and listen to the things I say and say, shut the fuck up, that's fine. But, you know, at the end of the day, with, you know, and I'm not tooting my own horn here, but, you know, 37 years of fucking playing games and about 25, 30 of them playing really competitive. You know, only in the last, like, couple of years, since MK9, did I really stop playing competitive. You know, I mean, now it's just about having a good time. But that doesn't change the aspect of throughout the years, the competitiveness has always been there. It's changed and it's morphed in different ways as far as what's considered the competitive side to it. But at the end of the day, I still play to win. You know, it just might not be against somebody else in Mortal 9, but I'll sit, you know, and I'll try to do a speed run through a Metal Gear or something, or I'll pop in a Call of Duty. Or believe it or not, I'll crack open fucking Street Fighter AE 2012, you know, and bust out some sumo ass or some shit. But, you know, I mean, I'm still competitive with it. So, I mean, I'm always willing to talk to them. I just, obviously, from, you know, the way things have transpired over the, you know, the last year.
That was a rough start. That was a rough start for the community at MLG this year.
You know,
that was kind of really rough.
You know, but it is what it is, and, you know, peace was achieved, and, you know, I hope, you know, I mean, I debate with Carlos over Twitter. It ain't, you know, nothing against him. It's somebody's got to be the devil's advocate, you know. I know everybody likes to do this positive reinforcement shit, but all that really does to you is
makes you
let down. It makes your letdown that much more painful because you had your hopes up of so much so quick, and it cannot, you know, like you were saying about McMahon, that took years to develop.
Yeah.
That wasn't a thing that he did in 2 years, and all of a sudden he was a multi-billionaire. He took what his father kept as a wrestling business and turned it into this over 25 years. You know, so I mean, for them, you know, it's kind of naive to think that they're going to whip this up that quick. It's got to go. I mean, even if you look at other sports, you know, look at a sport like soccer. Soccer was originally played with your hands. You know, and it morphed as time went on into what it's become now, which is the biggest sport on the planet, next to cricket. Which I don't know how people watch cricket, but then again, you got that Jamaican blood running through you, so you're probably a cricket fan.
I don't watch fucking cricket either. That shit is fucking stupid.
Any game that lasts 7 days is fucking stupid.
Man, I'll never understand that shit. Why the fuck would...
So, I got Chris G. So, what is finger cramp, so everybody out there knows?
It's like it's a media source. They make videos and stuff. Right now they're actually trying to work on like a bi-weekly thing going. Pretty much we make our weekly shows and stuff. You can check it out. Hashtag FGC. We got some ideas coming through. Some crazy stuff. Another show, What You Know. I mean, you know. Like, I just talk about, like, random teams that people just sent through. And, like, we're just trying to get things started right now. People in the FGC know it, but trying to get other people to, you know, learn the game and stuff. Like, they got babies guides and stuff for, I guess, people who kind of suck. And
are you trying to hint at something to me here or what?
For those who are novice in the game, finger cramp is providing informative services via their social media network to help gamers get more involved in the games that they revolve around their endorsed players.
Or as in Chris G's version, if you're free and you play like ass, we got some videos to help you.
Yeah.
There you go. Two versions for those who couldn't understand it the first time.
So, like you said, do you? So you're pretty much going to stick around local for a while now.
Wait, me?
Yeah, as far as tournament wise, what do you got coming up as far as tournaments?
Like I said before, season beatings. Evo guaranteed. I'm trying to go to Canada Cup, and I want to go to Japan. Like, everyone wants to go to Japan. But, like, most likely, I think I'll be able to go this year.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go to Japan to whoop their ass in MK9. Oh, wait, they don't play that game there. I'll be there.
Are Japanese girls into black guys?
What?
Are Japanese girls into black guys?
I'm sure they are. It'd be something different, you know. Whenever it's something different, they, you know, it depends on how dirty you want them. You want them down and dirty. Those are the ones that'll do anybody. But when you get those hoity-toities, I have experience with this. They don't like to go out of their race. White boys and black boys, it's hard. You know, it's especially when they're really hoity-toity. But if they're down to earth, yeah, they're cool with it.
The problem is their parents don't allow them to date black guys. I found out the hard way.
Their parents don't allow them to date black guys?
No, this happens.
Is it because of the... Oh, I thought it was a surgical thing. Okay, never mind.
Oh, no, it's like, it's not even just black people. It's like dating out of their culture, period.
I'm trolling. I'm being an asshole.
Okay.
Oh, man, I said surgical. I'm a dumb fuck.
Hey, Felice, I'm always down to go to my little karaoke joint, which, by the way, Troy, I got this nice, banging little karaoke place that me, Maxter, and Ed Fig wound up finding after Summer Arena.
Oh, really?
Over on 38th. Woo, yeah. Open till 7 in the morning, drinks all. After we left you guys at the bar, we went out. We stayed there till 7 in the morning drinking.
Damn.
And it's one of those places, like, inside an apartment on the 5th floor, you know, shoved away in the middle of nowhere. Definitely kick ass, dude. So we'll definitely do that, Mr. Felice. We could do a stream from there in a Woolay OBS production.
A Woolay OBS production. Yeah. That shit sounds like a fucking...
It sounds like one of those hentai videos just getting ready to explode. I will say this. I'm old, but I'm not old enough to be in Vietnam. But if I was in Vietnam, we would have won the war.
Just know that.
We would have won the war. I would have banged every Vietnamese girl, and they would have loved us for a long time after. Trust me. I would have changed the face of that whole country.
Yes, because they would be sitting there as like, whose baby is this? And I'm like, oh shit, the white man. They would have lost the war.
But you know, I'm gonna wrap this up because my numbers are dropping here, and I don't like getting underneath that 50 mark. So I'm at 55 right now, and it's, you know,
I'm starving myself. So
next week, yeah, I'm getting kind of hungry, and I got work in an hour and a half. Once again, I want to thank Mr. Empire Triforce for coming on, shedding a little light on the PL drama. That's not really drama, but and obviously Chris G taking the time out after his tournament to come on. Sorry we didn't blow too many people up, but you know, peace was achieved through negotiations. So it actually is a good thing, I think, for the community as a whole. And hopefully, you know, between everybody else, this, you know, eventually, you know, there ain't a Marvel, Street Fighter, MK scene. It's just a fighting game scene. And everybody gets kumbaya-like and accepts each other's games. I don't see it happening, but it's wishful thinking. At least until MLG picks up and somehow manages to get the Capcom games.
I don't think they'll ever get the Capcom games, honestly speaking. Because Capcom does not want to give them their games. That's just what it comes down to.
I know. They'll never. It's just the crowd's too rowdy for them. That's one of the reasons. The rowdy crowd and obviously the license issues. But Tekken Tag 2, maybe.
No, Tekken Tag 2 is going to be at Dallas.
Is it?
Yep.
I'll be at NEC.
Oh, that's why you're going to NEC?
Yeah.
I won't be at neither. Wait, NEC is when? December?
December, yeah. December 1st and 2nd, I believe.
If I don't go back to St. Martin in December, I may go to NEC.
Yeah, come down. What do you got to lose? What do we got? December, I think it's...
The 6th. I think it's the 6th because they usually have it where it... Every time they have a summer jam, it's always the first week of December.
I heard he changed it to December 1st and 2nd. I could be wrong. Huh? I could be wrong because that's a Saturday, Sunday. The 6th is a Thursday.
Then it's the 7th, 8th, and 9th. No. Oh, who knows? I guess we'll see what it is when the time comes.
But,
all right, guys.
All right, sir. I will let you go. James. Any shout-outs you want to get out there? Anything you want to plug?
Oh, well, yeah. Well, I'd like to for everybody to join the gamer life at Duckster at www.duckster.com with some sponsors. And everybody, Bifu Techie is going to be streaming Apex. And I'm working on trying to get him to stream Battlefield Arcadia's first major, which is the road to, well, Destination Saint Martin, road to VXG. So that's another sponsor of ours. So you can check them out at the videoxgames.com. Shout out to it's your boy Rolando. And that's pretty much it. Shout out to Nintendo.
Gotta love the power glove. I got no love for the power glove.
Yeah.
U-Force. It was all about U-Force, man. You know it.
Someone put Fuckster.com. Duckster. D-U-X-T-E-R. Are we making fun of my sponsors? What's wrong with you?
How are you scrolling?
Mr. Chris G, you got some people you want to give shout-outs to there?
Jesus Christ.
He loves you, too. He does love you. I was talking to him yesterday. He's like, yo, when Chris G comes on the show, just tell him I love him. So, Jesus likes you.
Oh, that's good.
All right.
And Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson. Fuck you guys. Thinking I'm trolling.
Oh, he was dead serious. He just made an honest mistake. Oop, our bad. My fault.
No, shut the fuck up, Felice. How's that?
Damn, where's the love?
That is love.
Oh, shit.
What about you, Mr. Jade's pimp?
No shout outs. I just got a question for Chris. When's the next FGC, hashtag FGC for Marvel? I love that show, man.
I don't know. We switch it up. I'll let Hack know, which is pretty much the leader of Finger Cramp. And we'll see what's going on.
All right, cool.
And guys, keep in mind, I'm going to be creating, apparently, courtesy of Triforce, I just brainstormed it, stomach condoms for gamer girls, so they don't have to tolerate having gallons of semen poured into them.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, shit.
So I will be, and I will be marketing them depending on what tournament event I'm at, so... I will be having an NEC branded stomach condom for some of those girls out there that are looking to move up in the community.
Oh, this is terrible.
Yeah, well, see, you make me bad. And Jesus loves you guys. Just remember that.
Gallons. This is terrible.
I'm gonna leave the stream open like I always do for a little bit, guys, before I. Actually go in my room and tap my wife, because that's what wives are for.
Yeah, that's not what wives are for.
No, they're all sort of cooking clean.
And cooking.
Oh, yo, wives are for companionship, man. They're the best thing I have.
No, a dog is for companionship.
No, a fucking dog is a goddamn dog. That's what the fuck a dog is.
It's for companionship.
There's no fucking companionship with no fucking dog. I can't fucking talk to my dog and rub its ass. What type of fucking neurotic bestiality shit is that?
I'm fucking German. What do you want?
Oh, shit. What the fuck's going on here, folks?
This is the Scheiste Hour. No. Nah, guys, next week, I got a couple of more guests booked already. Got to kind of weed through them, but I do have Sindel coming on within the next week or two.
The actual Sindel?
Come on, mm-hmm. Man.
How the fuck are you getting these people?
Yeah, how do you get these people?
Man, I've known these people for 20 years.
Wow. That's godlike.
You know, girl. She's actually she's pretty hardcore. She was Sindel and Serena in MK Mythologies, but she's a fitness trainer now too. Everybody's a fitness trainer. You know, everybody's a fitness trainer, but she's out in California. John Turk is out in California, working on getting Turk and her. I'm working on getting Anthony Marquez, Kung Lao. Philip on MK2 Shang Tsung should be coming on in a couple of weeks.
You wait, what? Yeah, I was about to say, where's the Shang Tsung guy?
I got it. Well, he had a little bit of an issue as far as he's a doctor, but for some odd reason he can barely operate Skype. So I kind of been trying to coach him through it, which is amazing. But Yeah, he's got his. Actually, I think he said his daughter's gonna help him. So, we'll have him in a couple of weeks. I mean, I'm also reaching out to the director of Legacy, the MK Legacy videos. You know, obviously, I know everybody's been requesting for Boone. I don't see Boone coming for a while, but I do see it eventually happening as it gets closer to release date. Obviously, Hector and guys, I'm looking out to get them on eventually. And, you know, like I said, I want to get guys, you know, more community-oriented guys on the show as well. Like I said, nobody in this community is less than another person. I don't care if CD Jr. wins 100 tournaments or Rio. You know, just because you ain't winning tournaments doesn't mean you shouldn't have a voice. So, you know, if people have something they want to reach out to me about, God bless the eyebrows. But if anybody wants to get on here, you just hit me up. Tell me why. I might deny you, you know, if I have something that's, you know, more pertinent at that moment. That don't mean I'm going to push you away totally. The only two guys I won't get on my show is Felice and Claude Von Stroke, because, you know, they got their own show, so they don't need to get on. And Triforce, you know, you're always welcome.
And I Chris, appreciate it, James.
Chris, you know, you're always welcome. But if you ever really, really, really get in that salty-ass mood and you want to put some people on blast, I hope you come on here to curse them out. Anybody, I don't care who it is. I don't care if your garbage man doesn't pick the garbage up right. Call me up, man.
Chris, one more question. You remember that UFGT panel when you said anyone who raw tags is a complete idiot? Why'd you do it at Evo?
If anyone understood Marvel, they would understand why I did it.
Why'd you do it, though? I don't remember.
I tried to get hit by the super while I was coming down. And that didn't happen. I was supposed to get hit by it and then roll. Apparently the super took 5 years to come down. And I got hit with it when I landed.
All right, well, guys, I'm gonna end this with Monday nights. Be sure to check out the Roulette Show with Mr. Felice and Claude Von Stroke. Even though Von Stroke is always Stroke and PL, but that's okay in my book. actually, I'm just breaking balls. Definitely check out their show, guys. They got a great show Monday nights. You know, nothing but love for these two guys. They do a great job on their show. So I'll give you a little bit of love there, Felice, but no spooning. And basically, guys, you know, once again, thanks for coming on. Thanks for everybody tuning in again. My number officially went to 46, where I'm depressed now that it went under 50. But next week, you know, come back same time, same place, same channel, all that good shit. And during the week, I'll let you know who I'm going to have on next. Shout out to Serato 1988, even Mr. OBS Homeboy Tyson. I know you want to stroke PL, but, you know. Negri, no, I'm sorry. Negri 6, there ain't no dick sucking going on.
What?
I don't know. He was the same guy that was talking about dicks before.
Yeah, this is crazy, dude.
All the OBS guys
attract so many homosexuals.
That's just the community, man. OBS toxic, staying up there at 4 in the morning. Obviously, shout outs to K Frog for coming on and putting the world on blast as always. Shout outs to that pain in the ass who was flooding the channel before. I don't know who I forgot what his name was. But he was a pain in the ass. But hey, I don't care. You're still here. Shout out to Mr. That's not the On Blast show. Yeah, his name is fucking douchebag cocksucker. Shout outs to Mr. Napalm for tuning in. As long as he ain't beating up my people watching the show, I'm cool with that. Shout outs to him getting banned on Test Your Might and then the site magically going down. Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, I'm starting to think that you did this, B.
I don't do nothing.
Oh,
I just pray to God. That's all I do. I'm a firm believer in what comes around goes around, and I think they're going to come back with an upgraded version. That's
what
my guess.
What the hell did they ban you for?
They didn't ban me. They banned Napalm.
Okay.
They banned Napalm for punching out Wonder Chef at Evo.
Oh, he deserved it.
What?
All right, James, I'm out right now. I really got to go. Sir. My stomach is killing me. I got to put something in it, so and it's not semen. Shut up. I knew that was a joke was going to come. But anyway, I'll catch you guys later, okay?
You got it, man.
See you, right, first.
All right, good night, everybody. Bye.
You know, I mean, I don't know. I mean, as far as the Napalm thing, I don't know. Were you saying he deserves it?
No, oh. I said Chef deserves to get punched for being a jackass.
Yeah, well, that's a given. Yeah. You know, I don't know. I guess he must be stroking somebody's, he must be somebody's fucking semen dumping ground to get one person banned for something that happened at an event which had nothing to do with the site. You know, but, you know, he's, I don't know, he's, you know, he came on my show one time and, you know, 2 weeks ago and basically bashed the show saying that I was... Basically, he made up what he wanted. You know, he liked to do the political spin on things. But thank God it didn't work. Anyway, Chris G, I will hit you up again in the next couple of weeks. If not, I'll catch you at definitely at NEC. You know, I don't know. If I'll probably maybe... I might actually start trying to attend a couple of big twos and crack out some of my guile.
All right, man.
So.
Bye, bye.
All right, sir.
See ya.
All right, Mr. J's Pimp. I'm gonna wrap this shit up, and I'm gonna drop you off. I'm gonna leave the chat going for a little bit, and then after that, you guys can slowly make the numbers dwindle away as I go to bed.
All right. Good night, James.
All right, sir.
I have a really good chance.